Hey there, thanks for watching WP Beginner. Today, you'll learn how to install and set up WordPress SEO plugin by Yoast. Aside from great content on your site, you need to make sure it's properly set up and optimized for search engines. The most comprehensive plugin to handle this is WordPress SEO plugin by Yoast. Now, please note that these steps are what WP Beginner recommends, and other experts might have their own preferences. If you're moving from another SEO plugin or theme framework, like Genesis, Thesis, or Headway, then you want to install the SEO data transporter to move all your SEO data over before deactivating it. If you have a brand new site, you can skip that step. After installing and activating the plugin, you'll see this SEO link in the admin area. We can go to SEO Dashboard to get started. Under General Settings, they have an introduction tour that you can follow to get an overview of the plugin. And here you can reset to default with one click if you need to start over with the setup. Next, we have tracking. If you want to send anonymous information to them, you can check this. We have it unchecked. Under security, you can disable advanced part of the WordPress SEO meta box. Checking it keeps other authors from making redirects and no index items on your site. Under webmaster tools, this area lets you add your site to your webmaster tools to some search engines. Just add the meta code for each here and click save settings. If your site is already on your tools area, then you can ignore this section. Next is the titles and meta. For title settings, keep this unchecked as WordPress SEO hasn't auto-detected whether it needs to rewrite titles for your pages. Site-wide meta settings, click Use Meta Keyword Tags. Under Clean Up the Head, check Hide Short Links for Posts and click Save Changes. The Home tab is where you fill out your title template or what shows at the top tab of your home page. Add the meta description about your site here and the meta keywords. The keywords are what your site is mainly about, and then click Save Changes. Post types let you choose the default title template that all posts and pages will show, the default meta description, and keywords. We recommend you use WordPress SEO meta box on each post and page to manually fill this information out individually, and I'll show you what that looks like in a minute. For these, we can just use title for the template, and that will bring in the post or page title into the URL. We'll click Save Changes here. Next is the taxonomies area. You can add the title template for these as well as for the description. The plugin picks up the descriptions from categories and tags. We'll leave all default settings and click Save Changes. Other are for special pages like author archives, date archives, search, and 404. We recommend disabling the author archive if you're a one blogger site. We'll leave everything else the same and click Save Changes. The next area we'll cover is social. With this, we can add Facebook information. Here, you add a Facebook admin so you can bring the insights into the dashboard. If you have a Facebook page, add that URL as well as the image URL and a description. To make it easier, you can also copy home meta. Down here is the image URL that will be used if there's no image on the post or page. When you're done, click Save Changes. The next is Twitter. We can check this to add Twitter card meta. This is great if someone retweets your links. People can see a summary of your post like this, and you can choose to show the summary or show the summary with an image. Once we add that info, we'll click Save Changes. For Google+, click Add Google Post Metadata and add the URL for the Google page for your business. You also need to go into Google Settings and add your site's URL in your About section. We'll save changes here. Next, we want to set up XML sitemaps. This is the fastest and easiest way to get your site indexed and to notify search engines about your new content. Make sure you check this box. For single author sites, check this to disable author user sitemap. The plugin automatically pings Google and Bing, but you can enable it to ping Yahoo and Ask.com as well. You can exclude post types from being added to your sitemap, like media attachments. Here you can reduce the number of entries per sitemap page if you run into memory issues. Next thing we're going to talk about are permalinks. This area builds on the permalink structure. It assumes you've gone into the settings permalink and changed it from the default link like this to something like this. Here you can remove the category from the URL. Next is enforce trailing slash. If you end your post with HTML, then you probably want to enforce the trailing slash. Next is to remove stop words from the permalink. They're common words like a, and, the, and Yoast believes you create cleaner URLs by doing this. We leave this unchecked as we disagree with that. The redirect attachment URL to parent post. All images have their own URL. If you don't want users to go to these image URLs, then check this to redirect to the parent post. The next item is good if you have a lot of comments on your site, as it disables the threaded replies from working for users who have JavaScript disabled, which is the case with most web crawlers. For canonical settings, just leave as default and click Save Changes. Next, we have internal links. This is the breadcrumbs and trail to the page you're on, and it's used by search engines like this. You have domain, blog, tutorials, and this is where the article is found. To get this, click Enable Breadcrumbs. Choose a separator. Here's the anchor text for the home page. Prefix for the breadcrumb path. This is the prefix for archives and for search and for the 404 page. And here you can choose to bold the last page of the breadcrumb. You can also choose to show the taxonomy for the breadcrumbs. We'll leave none. We'll save changes. The RSS Feeds section adds content to all your posts in a feed before and after the post. So when a content scraper copies your content, there will be a link back to your site, letting search engines know and readers know where the original source is. We'll leave the info here and click Save Changes. Next is Import/Export. If you use another SEO plugin, this is where you can import those settings. Since we've spent a good time setting all this up, you can also export all the settings as a backup for other sites or for safekeeping if you mess these settings up. Next is the bulk title editor. This lets you quickly go into each post that you had on the site before installing the plugin and update the titles to better SEO title. Once you're finished with them, you can click Save All. Same thing goes with the bulk description editor. This lets you give a better description of what each post is about for better SEO. The edit files allows you to create robots.txt file if you don't have one, and it lets you edit your htaccess file. As a beginner, leave these defaults for your site. Extensions are paid upgrades to take your site to the next level for SEO. And now you want to make sure you're customizing each post and page as you write them. This really maximizes the benefit of having the plugin installed. For example, I'm creating a new post. You'll see this new box on every post and page. Fill this out on every post and be as detailed about it as you can. Give it a focus keyword, SEO title, meta description, and meta keywords. Like, this is your focus keyword in the article heading, page title, page URL, content, meta description. Try to make all these yes. Then look at the page analysis and see if you can get all these reds and yellows to green. We'll leave advanced alone for now. With social, you can just keep what the default was from the settings. And when you go to publish, you'll also see this SEO area. It will give you a quick red light, green light if your SEO is good or bad for the site before you publish. Try to get green for every post. In your post writing workflow, make this one of your last things you do after you write your articles to increase your search engine optimization. I hope you liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, click on the like button below and leave us a comment. And if you want to receive more helpful videos, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and check out wpbeginner.com for more useful information on WordPress.